these other little funds and what they're doing. And they don't really have that much impact on the general fund, which is where all their tax revenues are going and where the majority of their expenditures are coming from. But this is the fund that when you're looking at how you did every year, this is the primary driving fund there. So I wanted to focus on what was going on there because most of those other ones kind of take care of themselves. And what I did is what you have here. And just to kind of explain how I had to go through some of this, a lot of your expenditures, some of them we pay on a monthly basis. You pay them the first of the month, a lot of your appropriations. So if you looked at it today, you would have 5 months of payments in there. Some of your other expenditures that we pay, because the bills come in a month or later, after the expenditures have occurred, if you looked at it today, you may only have 3 months of expenditures. So I had to go in and take some of those things and look and sort them into months. But what I wanted to do is say, okay, this is what it looked like at the end of 3 months with those adjustments in there. And then I'm giving you a picture of 1 month later what it actually looks like. And then we're going to look at some of the things that are a concern and kind of drill down from there. So if you look,
are y'all clear on that? Does that make sense to everybody? What we're doing?
Okay. So the first page is the, this is the general fund as it actually stands at the end of 3 months with those adjusted payments in the correct months. And you see that your revenues are at 17.66%. The majority there, you see that the tax revenues are at 16.43%. That's because your tax revenues do not come in until the second quarter. And then some of your other ones, miscellaneous and all those are low. And we'll get into why some of those are low in just a few minutes. On your expenditure side, if you look at it, everything is pretty much in line where it should be. It should be around the 25% mark. You're just a little high on some of those, but everything looks to be pretty much in line. So if you did a financial statement at the end of the first quarter, based on where you're at, you're about $3 million in the hole. But remember, because the majority of your revenues are going to come in the second quarter.
Actual
cash. Well, that's where it stands with what your cash has come in and what has gone out. I mean, you have fund balance, but it's
up to $2.8 million.
Yeah. No. That's your budget balance. That's if you have $40 million available, you've collected this amount. This is how much you have left to collect. This is how much you have left to spend.
Approximately or historically, what percentage of property taxes do we receive? Out of 100%, what percentage do we receive in that second quarter? Because I know you have something contested and late. Is that another just a ballpark figure?
I would say probably 85%.
And overall, at the end of the year?
At the end of the year, it is typically. 91 to 93% range. By the end of 5 years, it's usually about 98%. Okay, so if you look at page 2, this is just over a month later, and this is where things actually stand. So you see, you started to get in a lot of those tax revenues are back at 21% there, and this is really just about a month later. And this is not making any adjustments. This is where it actually was standing at. So you see, you got in some of those tax revenues. Your revenues are back up to 22%. Your expenditures, however, are looking at you're in the 38% range on some of those. And that is where we're starting to get raise some concerns. Even though we have some of these things that are going to come in, or some of these things that are front loaded, if you look at
I know a lot of them are front-loaded, so I understand that, and that kind of skews those numbers like that. But do we give feedback back to the expenditure departments that you've got noted over there that pay your 38% budget currently?
They have access to that anytime.
Okay, but do we keep them apprised of, on a quarterly basis, that here's where you're at the budget? Okay.
And they actually do that on a day-to-day basis, because as soon as they start putting in a requisition, it tells them, hey, you've only got this much money left, every time they do something.
Okay. I guess with that, I understand that. But that's usually a mid-level person that's spending the money over here, and the elected officials and department heads realize up here. That's why I want to make sure we're communicating with the other elected officials and department heads on that, so they don't get surprised when we say, hey, you're, you know,
120%
budget.
Yeah, or that they don't shrug their shoulders and say, well, I have no idea. And that's what.
They're all there. Okay. So if you look on the next page, on page 3, these are some of the revenue concerns, or some of the things we picked up on revenue. And again, the majority of those property taxes come in during the second quarter, so you can see that through month 30, at $6.6 million, we're already up to $8.8 by 11/7. Charges for service. Balance to prisoner housing. There's a little bit of a, it's not exactly how it seems on here, because we billed $123,000 for this year. $20,833 per month has been deducted from that. So if you look at what you've actually gotten in cash, you've only gotten in $81,000. So you're going to end up short.
There is a question between the Sheriff's Department and the city concerning the expenditure or the charges for inmate housing. Last year, the Sheriff made an adjustment in his per diem and reduced the amount per day from $43 to $35, which equated to approximately $165,000. The commission asked at that time that we reduce the budget by a corresponding amount because of the reduction in revenue. This was done because we had already completed the budget at the time we learned this. Now we bill this, the county, the finance department bills this to the city of Dallas. When we received payment back, it was short $20,833 per month. We contacted them, asked why. They indicated that there is an agreement between the sheriff and the city concerning that reduction, that amount of money has been reduced in order to go to the crime. If y'all recall, there's been a request each year for money to the crime lab. Each year, the county commissioners have determined not to allocate funds for that. So apparently, this has been reduced arbitrarily by an agreement. We've asked the Sheriff's Department for information on it. The Sheriff's Department said there is no agreement. The city has submitted a document signed by the sheriff in 2010 for an amount of $205,000 allocated for the crime lab. The city has calculated that that should be approximately $300,000, and therefore they have determined to reduce that amount of revenue by $20,033. Per month, which would be $250,000 at the end, if it continues. ask. We have contacted the city, we've had conversations with the chief of police. We have not gotten any, we've told, when we contacted the sheriff's department by email, that there is no agreement. The city submitted how this was calculated and also attached a copy.
And we submitted that back to the sheriff's department for them to review.
The city police chief and the chief deputy are to have a meeting. As of yet, I do not know that that meeting is taking place to address the issue. That's what we're.
But to start with, it costs what, $55, $58 a day to house an inmate?
It's about, you know, it's about $48.
Okay. And so?
We're now charging
$35,
and from that $35, you're getting an additional $20,833 per month.
Well, now they did raise the rate they're charging Nichols County for their 7 prisoners, so maybe that'll make a difference up somewhere.
Okay. Any other question on that item?